Dear students, this is my 15th video. Let's read the drama or the play The Tempest from line 125 onwards. You are aware of the context. Prospero is telling his past tale to Miranda. Prospero, to have no screen between this part he played and him he played it for, he needs will be absolute villain. Me, poor man, my library was dukedom large enough of temporal royalties. He thinks me now incapable. Confederates, so dry he was for sway, we, the King of Naples, to give him annual tribute, do him homage, subject his coroner to his crown, and bend the dukedom yet unbowed, alas, poor Milan, to most ignoble stooping. Here Prospero tells concerning his brother Antonio that he did not differentiate between what work he carried out and for whom or at the place of whom. His desire was to become the real Duke of Milan, and only my library he granted me, that is, my dukedom was limited to my library, as he considered me unworthy to be a ruler. He was so thirsty for power that to achieve this goal, he agreed to pay annual tribute to the King of Naples and be his subject. Thus, the free or independent Milan became subject to the crown of Naples. Poor Milan had to bow humbly before the King of Naples. Miranda, oh the heavens! With grief, Miranda exclaims, oh the heavens! Prospero, mark his condition and the event, then tell me if this might be a brother. Prospero is telling to Miranda, consider his behavior and its outcome, and tell me if this is the sort of conduct you would expect of a brother. Miranda, I should sin to think but nobly of my grandmother. Good wombs have borne bad sons. Miranda feels sorry and says, I think it is sinful or evil to think how such a noble grandmother of mine could beget such an evil son. Prospero, now the condition, the King of Naples being an enemy to me, inveterate hearkens my brother's suit, which was that he, in lieu of the premises of homage, and I know not how much tribute, should presently extirpate me and mine out of the dukedom and confer fair Milan with all the honors on my brother, whereon a treacherous army levied one midnight, fated to the purpose, did Antonio open the gates of Milan and in the dead of darkness, the minister of the purpose hurried thence. Me and thy crying self. Here Prospero says that being an enemy of mine, the king of Naples confirmed my brother's desire. That's why, on condition of a large sum of tribute and homage to be paid to him, he crowned him, that is to Antonio, as the Duke of Milan. Therefore, one midnight, a treacherous army was sent for whom Antonio opened the gate of Milan's fort. In pitch dark, the ministers who were sent for this purpose hurriedly took me and you as a crying baby. Miranda, alack for pity, I not remembering how I cried out then, will cry it over again. It is a hint that rings mine eyes to it. Miranda says, alas, what a pitiful condition. I don't remember how I cried at that time, but it brings tears in my eyes on listening to this. So she feels that she should cry again as this pitiable condition she hears. Prospero, hear a little further and then I'll bring thee to the present business, which now upon that without the which this story were most pertinent. Here Prospero says, listen further, then I'll bring you to the present situation which is now here, without which this story would be most irrelevant. Miranda, wherefore did they not that are destroyers? So Miranda inquires, this question comes to her mind. Why did they not destroy us or kill us then and there? Prospero, well demanded wench, my tale provokes that question. Dear, they durst not. So dear, the love my people bore me, nor set a mark so bloody on the business, but with color fairer painted their foul ends. In few they hurried us aboard a bark, bore us some league of sea, where they prepared a rotten carcasses of a butt, not rigged, nor tackle, sail, nor mast. The very rats instinctively have quit it. There they hoisted us to cry to the sea that roared to us, to sigh to the winds whose pity sighing back again did us but loving wrong. Here Prospero is telling her further, your question is very apt and fitting, because this story is such. But my dear child, they could not dare to do so. That means they could not dare to kill us due to the fear of the people of Milan who loved me so much. So in order to give better appearance to their evil deed that took us 5 kilometers away to the seashore. There prepared a poor boat with the rotten hide of an animal which had no tackle to move or row, and it had such a nasty stench that even rats would run away. The boat was stinking or had very bad smell. In that they put us aboard, they boarded us and left to the pity of the sea and wind. Even the wind seemed an our loving enemy. Miranda, alack, what trouble was I then to you? So Miranda is saying, alas, I must have become an additional trouble to you. Prospero, oh, a cherubim. Cherubim means an angel. Thou was that did preserve me. Thou didst smile, infuse with a fortitude from heaven. When I had have decked the sea with drops full salt, under my burden groaned, which raised in me an undergoing stomach to bear up against what should ensure. So Prospero is saying, you were an angel to me. It was you who preserved me. Your smile filled me with the heavenly strength. When my unbearable pain made me shed tears, that is, made me cry, your presence made me endure all the hardships and tragedy. Miranda, how came we ashore? Miranda is asking, how did we reach to the shore of this island? Students, here we end today. In the next video, we'll read further. Bye. God bless you all.